Good morning, students. How are you all today? Fine. And yes, it's always nice to see you after the tests and all, and good to see you all joining the class. So let's come to the topic that we have to discuss today. We have started with the chapter Ailing Planet from our book Hornbill. Those of you who were not here with us yesterday, and yeah, you've just got a maybe a little forgot what we have discussed or what you did before the break. Let me just tell you once again. Now here it is, this chapter, it discusses a very important issue, which was valid when this essay was written so many, many years ago. And it is still, you can say, applicable, and it is still valid even nowadays, okay? Ailing planet, it tells us about the condition of the planet. Who is an ailing person? Someone is showing symptoms of illness. Can the earth speak? No. But how is the earth showing that it is not well? Because what we see around us, we have changed the face of the earth, right? With our development activities, with all the problems, all the damage that we have created. Now, what is the realization? What is one very important message which is conveyed in this chapter? That is, we need to have a shift in our approach. We need to shift in our attitude towards the way we look at the earth, right? It is not the responsibility of one country, one nation, or one person. It is our responsibility. Each one of us is responsible for the condition of the earth. So we have to take care that we change our attitude, how we look at our planet Earth, right? So if I think like I have to take care of this area, this is my thing. But you know, like, yes, if we have problems in one place, it is definitely going to affect other areas. So we have noticed about, yeah, we talk about rising temperatures, we talk about global warming, isn't it? We talk about the quality of the air, right? So all we talk about the water quality. So this is the activities at different places. It might affect the quality of our life here. Right? So it is very, very important that we realize that this whole problem is interconnected. So we have to wake up and start taking action. And this essay, when it was written at that time, was the beginning of the green movement. Can you guess what is the green movement? Yes. What do you think it suggests? It is about plantation. It's about forestation. Right? And how, yeah, you know, planting of trees can solve a lot of problems. Right, not only about preventing soil erosion, about the quality of the air, also providing habitat to so many wild species. So when we talk about here, I would also like to talk about the importance of biodiversity. Yesterday I had shared a video with you all, and we really appreciated the various forms of life on this earth and what has happened to many of them, right? And since we're talking about when man has arrived on the scene, we're not talking about dinosaurs and others here. So since man has arrived on the scene, he has put so many lives of many species in danger, right? Many have become extinct also. And there are so many species, we are not aware about their existence even. So what is very, very important to note here, that we are not the sole occupants of this planet. We are sharing it with so many other animals, right? And we have to appreciate this fact. We have to respect the fact that they need as much space as we need. They have every right to be alive. And in fact, they are at least giving to the planet. We are here causing what? Destruction only. We have not contributed very positively, right? So we should really appreciate those people who are really taking out time and working for the benefit of the planet. We have discussed about the exploitation of the ecosystems. Which ecosystems are they? Yes, we talk about the fisheries, we've talked about the forests, the grasslands, and the croplands. How has man exploited all these systems? How has he exploited the fisheries? Overfishing, It's our, you know, desire or our consciousness towards a protein-rich diet. We're overfishing, we're overexploiting without even giving the time for these animals here to replenish themselves. So we're not giving that much time even. So when we exploit them to such an extent that they become rot to the verge of extinction, right? Forests, yes, deforestation. You just look around you and see, where are the trees? Where have they disappeared? Where have they gone? We are cutting them indiscriminately. And according to statistics, which we had discussed yesterday, the real figure is much more than what is there, right? So the number of trees lost per acres, every second we are losing the green cover. Are we replacing it? Are we planting trees? That is a question that we need to think about. So we have to really become aware of the needs of the planet. When we start addressing the concerns that all these ecosystems, they should be, you can say, perfectly balanced. They should not be overexploited. They should not be in danger. Then only we can think of having a happy, nice planet. Okay, right? The others are the grasslands and the croplands. So man has been exploiting them, that we have discussed, right? So the crops there. So we are using so much of fertilizers and pesticides and damaging the quality of the soil. Grasslands, the grass is there, the grasslands for grazing, and of course, many of it has been taken over, right? So we are there reducing the number of resources available. And we have to think in a way that we have sustainable development. Let us use these resources wisely. Once again, we have to remember that we are on this planet for a very short time. We don't own this planet. Nobody owns this planet, right? And of course, as I said, we need the planet. The planet doesn't need us. So we have to change our ways. We have to change our approach. We have to change our behavior towards the planet. Otherwise, yes, so many things that are happening, we are noticing, and we don't have any other place to go, right? Then why do you think there is so much of pressure on the resources? Why is there, you know, like, yes, here, all of a sudden everything is becoming scarce? We are also talking about population. This is what we are going to discuss today. We'll also talk about the industry's role in saving the environment, in taking care of the environment. Okay, right? Yes. So I'll just show you the... Let's start off with the reading part. Yes, here. So we had done this yesterday. Okay, right. Okay, so all students have been admitted now, right? So what are we going to discuss today? We're going to discuss about population. How population is a major factor in the, you can say, condition of the planet. How the population, it can be controlled, or it should be controlled, so that there is so not so much of pressure on the available resources. And yesterday here, all of you look at this paragraph, that how the population has multiplied. What do you think is the reason for such a rapid increase in the population? How life expectancy has increased, right? We have better health facilities, yes, and right, medical care is there, and yes, proper care of the newborn child and the mother, and that is why you can say, yes, there has been a rapid rise in the population. But just see here, the present world population is estimated at 5.7 billion. Now it must be much more than that. This was so many years ago, this essay was written. Every 4 days, the population increases by 1 million. So resources are limited, the population is increasing. What is the poor earth going to do? It is going to be in an ailing condition. So there are things that we can contribute, we can take care of, to solve this issue. Fertility falls as incomes rise. Education spreads and health improves. And thus, development is the best contraceptive. But development itself may not be possible if the present increase in numbers continues. Now, what is one of the reasons here, in or one of the ways in which population can be controlled? Education, development, right? And of course, as people become educated, they are aware of the problems of having a large family. So in a way, this population can be controlled. If people progress, they are literate, and yeah, everyone is there busy working, and so they are concerned about the health also. That is the best contraceptive, that means to control the population. But development itself may not be possible if the present increase in numbers continue. So we can't do much about the development if the population keeps on increasing. So people need to be aware about, yes, what are the effects of having a large family, how it is definitely going to put a lot of pressure on the resources. The rich get richer and the poor beget children, which condemns them to remain poor. Rich get richer. They are already educated. They're literate. They have jobs. They are aware. They have health facilities. They're improving their lives. But what about the poor people? They beget children, which condemns them to remain poor. They have more children. As a result, that cycle, it continues. They continue in that poverty, right? They are unable to come out of it because more children does not mean more workers, merely more people without work. So there are more children. Are they able to send all those children to school? Are they able to get an education? No, because they're not educated, they don't get proper jobs. And because, yes, they don't have a regular job. Most of the time, they will be what? Unemployed. So this is a vicious cycle. So where do we have to focus on? We have to focus on the people here, the poorer people, or the people who do not have to have access to what? Schools, right? To health facilities, who are not aware. It is not suggested that human beings be treated like cattle and compulsory sterilized. So we can't control the population this way, that sterilize the population, right? To check birth control. No, it cannot be done like that. But there is no alternative to voluntary family planning without introducing an element of coercion. That means force. So you have to be a little forceful when you want to what, adopt family planning. So some strict measures need to be applied so as to control the population growth. Yes, so we have to really take care of the growth of the population. The choice is really between control of population and perpetuation of poverty. Now look at these lines. Choice is really between control of population. Should, what are we supposed to do? Control our population? Prevent this population from exploding, right? How it is there, the numbers increasing every day. How many millions being added? And perpetuation of poverty. Perpetuation, a continuous state of poverty. So are we allowing it to continue, right? So we have more numbers, we have more people. What is going to happen? Poverty is going to continue. We'll not be able to remove poverty. We will not be able to improve the condition of the people. So we have to decide, how can we remove this poverty? By controlling population, right? Giving access or making it accessible. What? Health facilities and education, right? And being aware of all the schemes. And yes, so all this will go in a long way in helping in controlling the population. Now, India, yes, of course, we talk about China, India leading the pack, isn't it? The numbers here. The population of India is estimated to be 920 million today. Once again, it's going to be much, much more. More than the entire populations of Africa and South America put together. And we know that how a large population, it can create a big problem. So as you've noticed in the pandemic also, how difficult it is to provide all the health facilities, how difficult it is to provide all the facilities when you have such a large population. So something has to be done, right? No one familiar with the conditions in India would doubt that the hope of the people would die in their hungry hutments unless population control is given topmost priority. it's very, very important that we give population control the topmost priority. Now, for the first time in human history, we see a transcending concern. The survival, not just of the people, but of the planet. So we have to save the planet as well as the people. Transcending, crossing barriers, crossing borders. It is not only one country that is worried about the environment, that is worried about the planet. Everyone here, right? All the countries, all the people are worried. We have begun to take a holistic view of the very basis of our existence. Holistic. What is the holistic view? Yes? Not in parts. That, see, you cannot take care of one thing, right? So it is there. As a whole, we have to look at the planet as a whole. We can't divide it into parts. The environmental problem does not necessarily signal our demise. It is our passport for the future. The emerging new world vision has ushered in the era of responsibility. It is a holistic view, an ecological view, seeing the world as an integrated whole that rather than a dissociated collection of parts. So we have to look at the world as a whole, not as parts. Okay, right. Yes, sir. Is this clear to all of you? Is it? So what do we have to do? We have to make sure that, we all become aware. We need to control the population. We need to take care of the resources. I want to show you one thing here. Yes, this is, once again, a short video about Mother Nature. What a message is, if the earth could speak, if nature could speak, what do you think? And please, can you tell me, can you see the screen? Is it visible to all of you? Yes, is it visible? Can you tell me? Can you see the screen? Yeah, okay, fine. Let's have a look.
Yes, our future depends on when I'm flawed, I'm strong. When I'm faulted, I'm faulted. All of us. But I have fed species greatly, and I've starved species greatly.
So you're talking about the dinosaurs, my, right?
My forests.
Notice my forests.
How you choose to live each day, whether you regard or disregard me, doesn't really matter to me. Your actions will determine your fate, not me. I am prepared to be born.
So what is the most important message? Do we need the earth or the earth needs us? Yes? What is the most important message that we have learned from this very short clip here? It is like as if Mother Nature is speaking and telling that so many species have come and gone. Man has also come here. We have powerful rulers. You know, we've had such a great civilizations, they've all been destroyed, but nature has survived all this, right? And nature will continue even after us. So the least we can do is let us be so, I would say, awakened and enlightened and contribute our bit to saving the planet. And this is why this chapter is very, very important. I would say if it was relevant so many years ago, it is relevant now also. So today, what have we discussed about? We have discussed about how population plays an important role, right? Okay, yes, sir. Let's continue. So what is the view that we need to adopt? What is the view that we need? We have to change from a mechanistic view to a holistic one. So this is very, very important. Underline this if you have to. Right. Now, next, industry has a most crucial role to play in this new era of responsibility. What a transformation would be effected if more businessmen shared the view of the chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Woolard, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. He's not a chief executive officer, he's a chief environmental officer. He said, our continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental performance. So yes, here, if our industries are there concerned about the environment, it will go a long way in, you know, like improving the condition. So here, DuPont, right, the chairman of this very, very important industry, right? And what has he decided to do? He calls himself the chief environmental officer. And he says that we have to be concerned about the environment. And we know how much industries, they contribute to the pollution, isn't it? So whether it is air pollution or discharging the effluents into the water, right? So all this is there. And how much, you can say a major share of the resources are required. So whether it is about, giving power to them, your electricity, your coal, water, all these things, right? Manpower that is required, many industries, they, you know, cut down so much of what area is there, deforested, to build up those industries. So yes, so they have to give back to the environment what they have taken. Of all the statements made by Margaret Thatcher during the years of her prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current coin of English usage as her felicitous words, "No generation has a freehold on this earth. All we have is a life tenancy with a full repairing lease." In the words of Mr. Lester Brown, we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children. So no one has spoken more powerful words, right? So Margaret Thatcher, yes, the Prime Minister of England, and she has said, what is it? That no generation has a freehold on this earth. I don't own the earth, neither do you. No generation owns it because no one survives so long to claim, ownership of the earth. And we can't. No one has. You might have your personal belongings, your material goods, but you can't own the earth. And when we realize this, only then we can bring about a change, right? We are here on this earth as long as we are alive, right? And of course, here, let us remember, we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children. I inherited it from my, you could say, forefathers, right? From our ancestors. I will be leaving it for my children. You will also be doing the same, right? So what is going to be there forever and ever? Our earth is going to be there. How are we responsible for the condition of the earth? We are responsible that we make sure that we give it in a good condition to the future generations, right? So we have to take care of the earth. We have to own responsibility that, yes, we are, you know, inhabitants and we need to take care. And why is it so important now, you know, to take care of the earth? What are the things that have made us realize? What are the things that have made us realize that we really need to wake up and start caring about the earth? Can anybody tell me? Can anybody tell me what?